What is up, and welcome back to another Let's Play. Today is the epilogue, and we're starting part 10. So guys, I went ahead and I just did that mission that I mentioned in the last one. Our last episode, I should say. Or maybe it was a previous episode where I was going to get the link cable for us. For we can reach our final evolution and we're not just stuck as a choke. So I went ahead and I just did that. So here is the mission. You can see here, I had it be allocated to find Smoochin and Monsteel 47. You get 200 Pokédollars plus the cable link. Oh, link cable. Sorry about that. I know a lot of Pokemon fans are going to back me for that. It's required for us to evolve into Machamp. Also, it's required to evolve into Alakazam, Grabber, and the Golem, etc. But what we see here, guys, is that Snubbull went into the Luminous Cave. See here, he went down in there and he came back Grimble. This means he evolved. So as Alakazam is telling us, we can now evolve. Our appearance changes, we grow stronger. Stronger than ever. And what's going on here? Only one of us can enter. What button it was to talk to your partner? One of these buttons. No worries, but this is the epilogue, guys. We can now evolve and such. There's more fun, should be more fun areas. Yep, there's now more fun areas. We can now recruit even more Pokemon. One of them we have not seen yet. Here is the Rainbow Peak. That's out of the sick field. Buying those two will trigger another epilogue special mission, which we can then recruit Raikou, Entei, Suicune, and then Ho-Oh. We'll get into that later. You guys can see here, here's all the new areas. A lot of new Pokemon we can recruit. That's right. Also, that one is another Pokemon that's for Mewtwo. I forget how to trigger that event. But the aged events for the unknown. Ancient Relic for the Regis. Got the Frigid Cavern. Got these ice areas, which you can recruit Jinx now. Purchasing Southern Island will trigger another special epilogue mission to recruit Latias and Latios. Also, Final Island will allow us to be able to recruit Mew. One thing about it is Mew is very difficult to try and find. by the crater here just so we can recruit more fire types to our team. So right now, Torchic is the only fire type on the team. And it's good to have more of them. Means we want more adventures. More potential recruits, more adventures. You guys know this by now. I've been talking about throughout this whole series that we're gonna do everybody's own individual things. See, here's Medicham, just she mentioned something about Lombre. So now we're gonna talk to Lombre. Discovered a new dungeon, and I wish guys can tell us more about it. Whiskas has just given us dive. So now, the only way we can go to the Stormy Sea is if we had that with us, or we teach it to one of our recruits, and we just bring them along with us for the dungeon. That would be the more reasonable option, because trying to have it with us, there's chances if we die, we're gonna lose it. Said there, guys, is that now we can choose who we want to go in the dungeons as. So that now means, guys, the adventures of D-Nice Champion will begin. The adventure of D-Nice has now begun. So just for the heck of it, we're gonna go do this mission. But as you guys can now see, epilogue story, D-Nice Champion is now the leader. And we can set this to be whoever we want it. Say like if I wanted it to be Torchic, I can choose to be Torchic. It's maybe not in this one. But normally in dungeon in this game at least, we had the ability to switch the leaders inside the dungeon. But that might not be till later on though. What we're gonna do here is we're going to actually take the extra section myself. You'll notice I'm moving the moves to where I want them to be. it's this way so I can, use Sonic Boom from a distance, and when they get close, I can hit them with Spark. It's very effective for long range attacks. If the enemy's all the way across the room, you can hit them with it. Hit them with a Sonic Boom, they get close. Hit them with a Spark. Very convenient, comes in handy. It's very useful when taking on bosses, it means you can take them on from a distance. Get some hit time from a distance, take them out. The old saying goes, throw a few punches from a distance. That he wouldn't use specifically his moves. There's some cherry berries there. I don't necessarily need them, don't need those. I really want to see this is the first adventure where D-Nice is leading the team. We're going to have many more adventures like this where everybody's going to get to lead their own teams. They'll still be under our team name, but they'll get to lead their own teams and such. Right now, D-Nice is leading us into a new journey. You guys can see that he's one tile out of the way. I can hit him with the Sonic Boom. Eventually I will get more x-ray specs for the whole team. It's going to take time, but I'm going to get around to working on missions to get more x-ray specs and just store them in the storage unit. This way I always have one for the leader of the team. Let's see, what's our destination? I could have just set this to be floor 1, but that would have been too easy. So I figured, floor 7 is decent enough. And guys, here's our friend Smoochum. You guys can see there, D-Nice has made his first rescue. He led the team and he made his first ever rescue. And we got the link cable, which means now both myself and Torchic can evolve. So, like you guys saw, we can only evolve one at a time. And D-Nice is sleeping in our house. You'll learn that one thing is, whoever you're playing as, if you have any members on your team, they'll go back to their friend areas, and the teammate you're playing as will stay at your house until you decide that you're gonna change it up or whatever. You see, we got the news that we can talk about in more areas. So I'm going to go to myself. I'm going to join the team, make the leader. I'm going to take be nice off for a team. Now what we're gonna do is we're high enough level to evolve. So this is what we're gonna do. We're going to evolve. And we're now a Machoke. You guys can see that my appearance has changed completely. And here, we can come over here. If any new moves were learned during our thing, come here, see if there's anything new that we want. There's nothing new. But come over here to our storage unit, store some things, store that, and then store that. Store those things, and then we take out our link cable. There it is. You guys will see that the only way I can evolve into Machamp is by giving the link cable. And the same thing applies with any Pokemon who evolves via stones. As you guys know, for Pikachu, you need a Thunderstone. Vulpix, a Firestone. Certain Pokemon, Waterstones, etc. So you guys can see there by me giving the link cable, I'm now able to evolve into Machamp. And I've reached my final evolution just like that. So you guys do need the proper items to evolve. If you do need an item, if you do require an item to evolve, you will not be able to evolve without said item. The game won't allow you to do it. I've evolved, now it's time to evolve Torchic. You guys can see we're now playing as Torchic. I'm gonna visit myself. Stand by as we evolve. Also, guys, make sure to check your level. If you're in, scroll over to see if evolution is possible. I know evolution is possible because of our level. Because we were both beyond level 30, we were able to evolve. Certain Pokemon require certain levels. Some require certain evolution stones, etc. In this case, Torchic can evolve into his final form without needing any items. And the way this works, you just simply exit, go back in, you can evolve again. And he's reached his final form. And I believe he can learn new moves, giving his two evolutions. Yep. You can see here he's got a whole lot of moves. So the first thing we're going to remember is Blaze Kick. That's specifically only to his third evolution. And then when the fire punch the place under with. Double kick, bulk up, fire spin. So I don't remember bulk up. So I'm gonna get rid of mirror move. And that's all for him. I'll eventually learn more moves as I grow in level and such. You can also check everybody else's level to see if they are able to evolve. Just by going up to them, checking summary. And you can see here Cece is able to evolve too, so we're going to evolve her. But we're actually, we don't have the item needed to evolve Cece into our final form. We'll get that in the next video though. In the next video we'll have the item required for her to evolve into her final form. But right now she can evolve. I can tell you guys, we did train a lot of our recruits. So now Cece has evolved. You can evolve as many Pokemon as you like, as long as they're within level and if they require the items. You have said items. Let's see if she can remember anything. Nothing really that would benefit. I think D-Nice can evolve as well, if I was going to say. Let's actually check. Can D-Nice evolve? And he can. Alright, so now we're going to evolve the nice champion. Make CC stand by. And exit. Now, the nice doesn't need an item to evolve. You can just evolve like normally, as evolution is based on level. And you can see T-Nice has gone from 1 to 3. So he's now a trio. See if he can remain the moves on his evolution. We're gonna need a lot of money, probably like over 100k, just to be able to at least find areas now. Let's see. What can we do here? Sebastian can evolve. Nice, nice. Pierce can evolve it. Patrick can evolve. Victor can, Larry can, Gary. Okay, definitely can. Alright, so we're gonna go evolve Sebastian. He can only evolve once. because we don't have the necessary item needed for him. But, yeah, Sebastian would eventually become a shifter. So we're just going to evolve him. Yeah, Sebastian will become a shifter here when he reaches his full form. I'm probably going to do all these evolutions on camera. It is possible to evolve again, but like I said, we don't have the necessary item for him to evolve. Once we do get that, we will evolve him. Give him Fang Attack. Synthesis is good to have, but played by the AI, they spam the hell out of it. Won't even be like, it will be like a complete full HP and they'll just spam it for no reason. It's actually pretty annoying. Given their ability, the ability is chlorophyll, and when it's sunny out, they repeat the same move. So if they use sunny day once, they'll use it again. And in quick succession, it's very annoying. You can see there that Sebastian can't evolve anymore. Well, not yet at least, but let's see. So now we go back to me. Take off Sebastian. Move back to Blaziken. Cool. And then you guys will see that we've got new areas to explore. We've got Stormy Sea, Solar Cave, and Wonderful Pond. We're gonna go to the Solar Cave. And you guys will see here that now I can, in this dungeon, I can choose to be Torchic if I wanted to. Blaziken. Choose to be Blaziken if I wanted to. Crap, DMS has my X-ray specs. Well, I can't see anything because he has my X-ray specs. But you guys can see we got 4 potential recruits. Still the same moves that I have, but Blaziken has new moves. Now my moves are twice as strong because I've evolved twice. I was wondering good if I kept my X-Ray, give Champ my X-Ray specs. I remember to get that back after this. Well, actually, you know what, guys? Isn't the longest one as Blaziken? You guys can see there that move increases my attack and defense. Very useful. And we just encountered our first trap. That was a sleep trap. It basically sprays sleep gas that makes you sleep. There are ways you can prevent that from happening. You can destroy the traps, or you can, or you know, if you increase your IQ up, you'll learn the non-sleeper IQ ability, which no matter if a Pokemon tries to put you to sleep or you step on a sleeping trap, it will not put you to sleep because you can't sleep at all. Okay, buddy, you gotta be kidding me. You missed twice. I'm looking for an Abra Drowsy Spine. We already got a Beldum, which we're gonna train. It's gonna be a while to level it up, but we will train it. Also gonna start doing more missions too, try to get our team rank up. The higher our team rank is, the better. There's more potential recruiting Pokemon, which I wanna recruit. Join us. Always make sure you're doing lots of missions, increasing up your team rank. If you notice there, that move did 20 damage. It's based on your level. So apparently that Natu is level 20. If it were any higher, it would have done more damage. But given that it's only level 20, it's only going to always do level 20. Always do 20 damage. Same with my Seismic Toss. Even I'm level 36, and so we're going to do 36 damage. Also another thing here to you guys that we'll get into what it does, if we can find them. We'll get into what they're for and what they do. If you guys noticed, we picked up a key. But what is it for? Like I said, you guys, we'll find out here. I'm switching back to myself. Like I said, you can switch out anytime in these upper level dungeons. And there, Meditite wants to join us. We've already got Meditites, but it's always good to have more. Mark. You can see Mark was level 30 and just went up. I was like, okay, looks like he's going up pretty high in level. Complain about it. It's less grinding for us to do. You should be able to evolve given this level, but I could be wrong about that. I know one of these forest things. Things that thing that I was talking about earlier. And there, guys, we just stepped onto another trap. That was a sticky trap. It basically makes one of your items unusable. It's a huge pain to deal with. What's even worse is that we can't see where we're going. Is D-Max has our X-ray scope. So we're gonna try to recruit either Mr. Mime or an Abra. My hope is an Abra. Just because we can get Alakazam by using another link cable. Whoa. I did not count on this happening. You can see there, if I didn't have non-trader on, I would be attacking my partner right now. But because of my non-trader ability, I don't attack my partner. Also, yeah, be careful when you're coming in here, guys, because these are our psychic Pokemon. And as you see, if you're a fighting type, they do massive damage against you, especially at my level. So always be careful, guys, because you never know what you're going to encounter. Always make sure you're grinding up your levels, still. You don't want to come into an area and you're underpowered and you're just going to end up getting beat. This over here is a sludge trap. Turns any food items you have into... basically, it just turns your food bad. I love how he just kind of drop kicked him. Yeah, I've never had him a champ on my team before. I've never seen his move animation for that. That's actually pretty funny. He just like drop kicks him. This is a weather band. It will protect us from